areas of work and what exactly we do for employers, what our mission is, and how we do assist employers in the province, and also some topics that we cover as an organization in terms of training and consulting and advising employers on. I'll also give you an idea of who the board is composed of, our board of directors, and the staff in the office, and then I'll also go over our system partners, and at the end, I'll open it up for any questions that you may have about the OEA. So the OEA was established in 2008 after many years of requests and, I guess, lobbying by industry to the government. It was identified that there was a gap in terms of resources for employers that were going through issues pertaining to workers' compensation and occupational health and safety in this province. So we're a not-for-profit organization, and we're not government or WCB. We are funded through the WCB, and actually what we like to say is we're by employers for employers, as we are primarily funded through employer premiums to the Workers' Compensation Board. Now, I will mention throughout the presentation, I may refer to Workers' Compensation Board of Nova Scotia as simply WCB, and also if you hear me saying OSH, I'm referring to Occupational Health and Safety, and I mean, most of you probably already know that. When I first started here a couple of years back, it took me a day or two to realize what OSH meant, so I'm just going to do you all the courtesy and let you know right out of the gate. I will mention, so we're self-governed by an industry-based board of directors, and I will get into the board in a little bit more detail later on in the presentation. And we service all sectors in the province of Nova Scotia, any region, and we deal specifically with employers or management groups. We have one office in the province, and it's located in Bedford, Nova Scotia, and it's on 36 Brookshire Court, which is just off of Hammes Plains Road. So our mandate, our areas of work, as I mentioned, we focus, our primary areas of work are in occupational health and safety and workers' compensation. Now, we have identified intersecting issues that pertain to the work that we do, specifically in human rights, employment standards, and human resource management. So when dealing with workers' compensation or occupational health and safety, the issues or the matters at hand aren't necessarily categorized by just one of those two fields. So through navigating employers, we have identified that sometimes the issues do intersect into human resources management, so processes, best practices, and also employment standards when it comes to dealing with the application of legislation, looking at policies and processes, and human rights, of course, which sometimes comes into play when dealing with, for example, discipline or termination of employment. So what we do. We provide expert advice and leadership. We provide answers to questions pertaining to the fields that I mentioned in the previous slides. Navigational support and assistance and advocacy. So an example, I guess, of the advocacy piece would revolve back to a draft regulation that was presented in 2014 by the Department of Occupational Health and Safety out of Labor and Advanced Education in the province. And through consultation processes, the Office of the Employer Advisor went around the province and had consultation sessions with groups of employers spanning from anywhere to 20 to 60 people at a time, and essentially just outlining the changes that would be coming for employers. And through those consultation processes, we identified that many issues that may arise for employers in the province. And through collaboration and working with the Department of Labor and Advanced Education, the decision came through that those drafts would be paused for the moment for further review. So that is an example of the OEA advocating on behalf of employers in this province. We advocate on many different issues that employers may be facing in the province, but primarily we're focused on WCB and OHS system issues, acts and regulations, policies that pertain to those. What our office tends to see is the more complex claims that employers are facing, and we do quite a bit of case management assistance with employers. When it comes to occupational health and safety, we deal with compliance orders, administrative penalties, and complaints. Now, we also commonly help employers with appeals, and we help in preparation for the employer going into appeals. Now, I will mention that the OEA does not represent employers at WCB or WCAT appeals in oral hearings. We definitely assist with the preparation of the employer going into the hearings or the oral appeal, but the OEA will not physically go into the appeal when it's an oral hearing. We do help with letter writing and submissions when it is appeal by submission or written submission, and we do help employers draft those all the time. So I do also want to mention that the opinion that OEA may provide an employer does not constitute a legal opinion, as we are not a law office. The best way to probably put it would be that the employer advisors in our office more or less consult with the employer or the management team, providing expert advice. So I'll go over our mission here, and so we like to say, our slogan, I guess, is navigating employers in the right direction to create business success in Nova Scotia. So how we do that, training sessions, we do an annual conference, and we attend several business association meetings. So I will mention our training schedule is out on our website right now for 2016, but that's changing all the time and being updated. So if you go to our website, which is listed on a later slide here, and you're interested, you may find some training courses that may be relevant to you and your workplace. But our conference, which is an annual conference, is being hosted this year on June 21 and June 22. And it's done in collaboration with McGinnis Cooper Law Firm. And we tend to theme the two-day conference. Day one is usually looking at employment issues from a legal aspect. And we have a group of labor lawyers from McGinnis Cooper that do the presentations. And that's hosted at their office downtown Purdy's Wharf. And there's more information about that on our website as well. And then day two usually tends to focus on more of a technical aspect. We usually have doctors come in. And last year we had a doctor come in and talk about permanent medical impairment. So right now the agenda is still being finalized, but once it is, I'd be more than happy to circulate it if you do provide me with any contact information. And also it will be up on our website. And I also mentioned we attend several business association meetings throughout the year. This year we've been involved in the newly created Office of Regulatory Affairs and Service Effectiveness. We attend industry annual general meetings and often host trade show displays or that sort of thing, just to be raising awareness of our organization. And we do plan on attending the tie-ins annual meeting here is coming up later in the year, and we're looking forward to that as well. So we'll be more than happy to meet with some of you face-to-face. Now, I'll talk about our Core and Core Plus services. So these are training sessions that we host. Core sessions, which I'll outline some of the topics covered in Core in a coming slide, but essentially what Core means is it's more entry level. It focuses on the basics of a topic such as navigating the Workers' Compensation Act. So this is for managers or employers that are really just looking for the foundation, the basic information when dealing with these acts. So Occupational Health and Safety Act would be another one. And then our Core Plus services and programs are designed to be more in depth, usually in a longer setting, a day, full day, or at least half day sort of thing. And often they may require one of our core sessions as a prerequisite, as they seem to dive a bit deeper into the issues, and they may require some background knowledge to do that or to be relevant for the attendee. And then, as I mentioned, we do advocacy and consultation. So anytime issues cross our desks that we feel employers, a broad range of employers will be interested in, we'll host consultations, and we travel across the province to deliver those, and obviously those are free of cost. So how we assist employers, we like to think that our main asset in the office is the advisors. And now the advisors bring a vast amount of education and knowledge and experience working in the industry, in Nova Scotian industry and with employers. We've had one of our advisors has worked in the hotel industry for over 8 years. One has been offshore, one comes from a legal background, but really we like to think that the knowledge in the office is our main asset, and that's really what has shown in the past that has helped employers through the issues that they've been dealing with. But how we do it now, so we go through meetings and discussions with employers. We'll come on site or we'll host meetings here. We also do have a training space here at the office. We'll do meetings with the owners of the management team. We review files case by case pertaining to WCB and OSH, and we offer advice and assistance on those. We participate in conference calls, often with other representatives from the Workers' Compensation Board or the Occupational Health and Safety Department, or with the management team in-house and office or ownership. And we do appeal support and letter writing and preparation, so often referred to writing or phantom writing, but we'll essentially help the employer write through or write the letter when dealing with maybe a worker or providing a warning or a submission for an appeal, a policy being drafted. But that is the assistance, that's the sort of assistance that you'll find here. The education I mentioned, we provide through our training, Core and Core Plus, and also our consultation sessions, and then, of course, system advocacy. Now, I will mention that the dealings with our office are completely confidential. You won't have to worry about any information being released without consent, of course, to the WCB or OH&S, labor standards. As I mentioned, we are an independent society, and the dealings with our office are completely confidential. We will get you to fill out a consent form when coming to us with any issues that we may have to navigate you through, but we do want to mention that it is a confidential service that we provide here. So some of the training topics included. So for Core, we focus on the entry-level topics. So as mentioned, WCB navigation, occupational health and safety navigation through employment legislation. And we also do a course in collaboration with the Workers' Compensation Board on my account, how to use it, how it works, the benefits of that platform. And that's actually coming up on April 7th. That's our next training session that's coming up. So if interested, please feel free to reach out. And once again, that information is on our website. So our Core Plus sessions, now there's more topics than you may see listed here, but for the most part, they cover topics regarding WCB case management, managing mental health, from pink slips to handshakes, which is the name of a course, and it's focused on the termination of employment, or essentially how the process should go, the right way to do it sort of thing. We focus on drug and alcohol use and testing, investigations in the workplace, our JOSH for managers, which is JOSH stands for Joint Occupational Health and Safety Committees. So we'll coach management teams on the proper ways of implementing a JOSH committee there. Accommodation and return of work, letter and submission writing, as I mentioned, for employers. And of course, appeal preparation. And another course that we'll be offering this year is job demands analysis. So I'll go through some of the common issues and requests that we see here in the office. So definitely one would be disability case management. Now, I can't even get into this one with you because it's certainly one of the ones that come across our desks quite a bit. But I'll be more than certain that our advisors have vast experience in dealing with case management pertaining to disability. Letter writing, or phantom writing, as I mentioned, often we draft a copy for an employer or a manager, and they will review it and make the required changes and then use that. So I'll, just to give an example that may pertain to your industries. So often hotels or bed and breakfasts, the sort of questions that arise from those types of employers would pertain to hiring part-time or seasonal employment. Questions regarding disciplining temporary workers compared to seasoned or tenured employees often crosses our desks. Now, obviously, there's different attitudes in employees that know that, you know, it's a summer sort of job. And then there's employees in the same workplace that work there year round or full time. And often we tend to see many questions arising on how to approach issues when dealing with the sort of mix of that in a workplace. And the requests often revolve around asking one of our advisors to coach a management team through the process of disciplining a worker or inputting a policy, how to provide appropriate warnings, the documentation that should be kept, and of course, termination when it comes to that. As mentioned before, appealing decisions that come out of WCB. Many employers often contact our office, and we will look at the file, and through navigation, we'll decide if there's merit to appeal a decision. Now, our office will also tell you if the decision was the correct one, or if there's no merit in an appeal. We're not solely here to just appeal things per se, but we will look and see that and make sure that the act has been applied correctly. And if that's the case, then that's about as far as the file will get with our office if the appeal is the only, I guess, question or concern. But at the same time, if something is identified that may merit an appeal, we will be more than happy to assist you with that. And then we also see quite a bit of general occupational health and safety questions regarding around safety and the compliance piece. So once again, another example, when dealing with parks or campsites or outdoor swimming pools, some of the questions that we commonly see coming out of your industry are regarding the intersection of occupational health and safety and then public safety. So when a workplace is outdoors and it may overlap with what may not be considered a workplace, but there might not be, you know, defined walls or boundaries or borders that are separating these things, there's many, I guess, questions that arise out of that in terms of, you know, what are my responsibilities, what are my liabilities, how do I make sure that I'm compliant and I'm operating a safe workplace here. So that is something that comes out of the industry quite a bit. I've been advised by some of the advisors in our office that there's many questions that come out of your industry regarding those sorts of questions. And then I guess another main one would be the creation of workplace programs and or policies. So that is something else that we assist employers with. Common in the hotel industry is actually programs on safe lifting. That's something we've seen quite a bit of a rise in those sorts of questions coming in the last little bit from the hotel industry, a bit more specific. But other sorts of common policy or program requests are revolving around drug and alcohol related policies. Vacation and leave, and I can mention a few more, but I don't want to go too far into it. But once again, if you have any more questions, please feel free to ask. And I will mention, when it comes to our training or policies and programs assistance, we will do customized topics or pieces that pertain more particularly to your workplace. Upon request. Now, mind you, like I said, the knowledge is really our main asset here in the office. So I would be more than confident that if there's something more specific that you're seeing in your workplace and may feel that you need assistance on, or a nice training session or meeting on site would be helpful for your workplace, then that's something that we can definitely develop and put on for you upon request. So we've done that sort of thing quite a bit in the past, and I just wanted to mention that because I guess it's not really written anywhere that we'll do more customized sort of work that pertains to your workplace. By no means are the services that we offer cookie cutter type of thing where they're set in stone and this is how they are and this is what they cover. Often our training sessions develop organically midway through because they're very informal and questions will start to flow, and then the audience will have more specific questions on a piece of the training content, and the time may be utilized to really dive into that a bit more, and that we do see often as well. So I mentioned it's an industry-based board of directors, and we cover diverse sectors in the province. So just to give you a visual of who sits on our board, starting from left to right, I'll just name them off and the organization that they represent. So Tina Lane, far left, she's COO and president with the Merit Industries, their manufacturers. Next to her is Jordy Morgan, and he's VP of Atlantic with Canadian Independent Business, who some of you may be members of as well. And then next to him is Juanita Spencer from the Spring Garden Road Area Business Association. And we have Al Angrenon, who is with Forest Safety Nova Scotia. And next to him is Rick Fian, who is our treasurer on the board, and he's a CA, and he's with Wearwell Garments out in Truro. And next to him we have Christopher Ipe, who is a lawyer with the Canada Post Corporation, and he focuses specifically on workers' compensation with that organization. And then next to him, we have Jim Cormier, who's VP of Atlantic for the Retail Council, and he represents retailers in the Atlantic provinces. And then we have Henry Bissers, who is our board vice president on the far right, and he's with the Nova Scotia Federation of Agriculture. He's the executive director over there. And I'll go mention missing from this photo is Bernadine McCauley, who is our board president, and also Christine Brothers, who is focused on HR, and she's with Candace Santiva, who are located out in Truro as well. So I added this information on this slide. I did just go through it, but the slide is available for everyone. The slides, I should say, are available for everyone just in case they wanted that information. I thought it was important to include. And then I just thought I'd give you a visual of the staff as well. Far left, you'll see Mary Morris, who's been with the OEA right from 2008 inception. And she's the executive director and also a senior employer advisor. Next to her would be the second longest employee of the OEA, Angela Peckford, who's been with the organization almost 6 years. And she comes from a legal background, or I should say a legal education, and she spent time at the WCB and also at the Department of Labor and Advanced Education. And then we have myself. I'm the manager of business operations, and I've been with the organization since 2014. And then we have Jeanette Coombs, who is the newest employee of the organization, and she's been with us since October, and she's also an employer advisor. So as you can see, we have a small staff, but we do quite a bit of work. We like to think we're high-powered for such a small team. But we've gotten great feedback in the past in terms of the work that we've done for employers for being such a small staff. So I included that information as well, just in case you'd like to have those details. So I'll talk a bit about our system partners as well. So we are a part of, we work hand in hand with the workplace safety and insurance system. And that's comprised of the Workers' Compensation Board, the Occupational Health and Safety Division, the Workers' Advisors Program, and then the Workers' Compensation Appeals Tribunal. So we are partners with these organizations, of course, as the OEA, and so is the Injured Workers Association and WCP, which is the Workers' Counselors Program. So I think that was important to mention, just so you get an understanding of I guess, the full system of partnership that we're working within and in collaboration with. And coming near to the end of the presentation here, I didn't mention it was short, but I do want to mention the Small Business Toolkit. Now, this is a great resource if you're not familiar with it, and it was created in collaboration with the WCB of Nova Scotia, Department of Occupational Health and Safety, and several industry safety partners, and we also collaborated in the rollout process of this safety toolkit. Now, it focuses on small business, medium size for the most part, but you know, there will be information that's relevant to all employers in the province, and it's a great little toolkit to have in the workplace. It offers easy-to-use toolkits, guidelines, and also downloadable forms in terms of, for example, an injury report. Now, we have several hard copies on hand in the office, and we distribute them with our training programs. Now, of course, this resource is free of charge for anyone in the province. There is also an online version, and I've added the link here on the slide. But if you are interested in a hard copy, you can obviously reach out directly to the department, but we'd be more than happy to mail you one out as well. As I mentioned, we have plenty of copies here on hand. But I think it's a great tool that employers, especially if you're just starting out a new business or that sort of thing, it's got some great information that will help you through some issues pertaining to small business, or sorry, workers' compensation and occupational health and safety. So that actually brings me to the end of the presentation. Hopefully I've covered who we are, and you have a better understanding if you've known of us before. Hopefully you have a better understanding, and if you hadn't known of us before, then hopefully now you realize what we can do for you and how we can help. As I mentioned, we're by employers for employers, and we will do what we can to ensure business success for you. So if you have anything that you heard or something that you may think that you need more information on, please feel free to reach out directly to me. I have some contact information here, and I can answer any of those questions. I'll also stick around for a bit if you have any questions that I can answer right now, if you'd like to speak to Tiffany, and maybe she can direct you through to me or to the office. But thank you for joining me today, and hopefully you've learned about us.
Thanks, Iyab, and thank you for that informative presentation on OEA. As you can see, you can jot down Iyab's contact information now. However, I will also include that in a follow-up email. I did just want to send out a heads up about space still being available during the half-day workshop on March 30th. That's taking place at the Chocolate Lake, Best Western Chocolate Lake Hotel. I will also provide a link to the registration form in the follow-up as well. I'd like to thank Iyab for the great presentation, Tourism Nova Scotia for their support, and to everybody who could join us today. Thanks, everybody, and have a safe long weekend.